Hello, our viewers. Welcome to Girl Redefined with me, Edith Wanjira, where we empower each other with the word of faith, with information and knowledge as girls. On today's program, we discuss how to navigate through life or the challenges we face as teenage girls. Today, we address teenage girls. On to our first topic, as teenage girls. Teenage is the age between 13 to 19 years. During our adolescent years or our teenage life, we always want to fit in. We have the desire, we want to fit in, we want to look like someone else. We also have our friends who dress in a certain way, who look like a certain way, and this creates discontentment in us. We always want to look a certain way like them or the celebrities. In this culture-defined world, we have to stand our position and be a Christian-defined girl. On our point number two, validation or approval. We want to be approved. We want others to approve us. We want others to validate us. As the word says in Galatians chapter 1 verse 10, it says, whose approval are you seeking? If you are seeking the approval of men, then you are not the servant of God. And we are striving to be servants of God. As we work in the kingdom of God, we want to be associated with the kingdom of God as servants of God. In this world, don't seek approval from anyone. Seek approval from only God. Only God can approve you. And you are beautifully and wonderfully made in God's image. That point, as teenage girls, we face the challenges of temptation or certain urges. It's an age where we are in adolescent age. We took on a msisimuko. We feel a certain way in our bodies. We should not address the desires of our bodies. Remember, this body is not your own. This body belongs to the Lord. At a certain age, the word says in Ecclesiastes, there's a time for every activity under the face of earth. Do not give in to the desires of your flesh. As the word says in Song of Songs, chapter 8, verse 4, dear daughter of Jerusalem, do not arouse or awaken love until it so desires. That time will come, a time when you will desire or you have to give in to the desires of the flesh. But as for now, do not give in to your desires. Let us focus on our studies, focus on our destiny, focus on what is important in our lives. On to the fourth point. This is about living the Christian life. We have challenges as teenage girls. We don't want others to know we are Christians. We don't want others to know we go to church. We don't want others to know that we are associated with the church, especially those who are in high school right now or those who have finished their class 8. You are going to join high school. You are going to join CU. When you go there is always CU. And you'll find that you don't want to be associated with those who go to see you. Being a Christian is not being outdated. See you, Shamba. Stick out. Do not usitake ukwe, I have to follow this clique to look cool. You don't have to look cool. You can be cool in Jesus' kingdom. You can look cool in Jesus' sight. So do not give in to your friends. Do not give in when they tell you, when you shamba, do this, take this alcohol, let us go for dinner. Do not give in as a Christian. Do not give in. The word says in 1 John chapter 2, verse 15 to 17, do not love the world and anything in the world. Whoever loves the world does not have the Father in him. Let us desire not to love the world, not to love the things of the world, but let us have the love of Christ in us. Let us reflect Christ in our lives. Hata mtu akikuona, mtu akitembea, anaona enyewe ule msichana, enyewe huyu ako na principles zake. Ule msichana anaweza itwa Christian. Usisimame mtu anashangagai, mtu anasema ameokoka, sileta pia anakuanga nazo. Because the people you walk around with, and the fellow students, your fellow students at school, know you better. Another point, as a teenage girl, you're going to face self-esteem issues or confidence. You have little little belief in yourself. As a teenage girl, you are made in the image of God. You are made in the likeness of God. Whatever you desire, whatever ukiona mtu unasema nataka kuwa kama yule mtu, nataka one day I want to be like that person. Every day you wake up, look up, look in the mirror, tell yourself, I am beautiful, I can make it, I am going far. Whatever desires you have, put them in prayer also. And it's very important as a teenage girl. Always pray, always pray. As a teenage girl, this is the right time to build a foundation in your life. You build a better foundation in your life with prayers, with the word of God. Always read the word of God. It will give you knowledge, it will give you the truth, it will empower you even with more information. You will realize and learn many things you are not aware of. And every day, make sure every day you read the word of God. It will help you so much. And always, whatever you pray about it, practice it and do it. Prayer without action is dead, or faith without action is dead. As you pray about these desires, as you pray about these temptations, always tell the Lord, give me self-control, and practice that self-control daily. Practice that self-control. Genesis chapter 1 verse 27 says, we are made in the image of God. Male and female, He created them in the image of God. Whenever you feel like you are down, whenever you feel like you are not worth it, talk to yourself. And another thing as a teenage girl, always talk to yourself positively. Do not talk to yourself negatively. It will impact your mind, it will impact your soul. Always talk to yourself positively. Tell yourself, I can make it, I can do this. Whatever challenge comes your way, always take it. And in this life, as you grow up, as you transition into adulthood, you'll find the chances you get or the opportunities you get, no one gives you or hands you and tells you, take, this is the opportunity, you can do this, you can be this. No, you have to take it, you have to grab it. Even the word says, the violent take it by force. Create your own space, create your own space. You can also be a leader at your age. You can also lead your peers at your age. You can let them know that if so and so says this is the way to go, if we follow this, there will be no consequences. Another thing as a teenage girl, have principles for yourself. Stick by your principles. Stick by your principles. The moment you go against your principles, they are not your principles anymore. The moment you go outward or you negotiate about your principles, they are not your principles anymore. So as a teenage girl, I urge you, stick out and speak up. Let people know this lady has morals, this lady has principles. And as you transition into womanhood, as you build a foundation as a teenage girl, you'll be at a better place in this culture-defined world. You'll be at a better place as a Christian-defined girl. Let yourself be defined in Christ, your identity in Christ. Let it speak louder for yourself.